Yo, what's going on, guys? JC here. And what we're doing today is an updated version of how to get map edits onto your DayZ online and or offline servers. So we're going to be using DayZ Editor. Again, if you don't know how to get editor, you must have a PC version of DayZ. You go to the Steam Workshop. You literally right here just type in editor. Here it is. You just subscribe to it. Close this down, close down your launcher, reopen your launcher. It'll automatically install the mod for you. And then you just, for instance, you come up here, you type in editor, it's right here. You load the selected or the dependencies, and then you're good to go. Once you hit play, it puts you into an offline version of the game, which allows you to make map edits. So if you also, for instance, if you didn't want to edit Chinaris or Livonia, say you wanted to edit Deer Isle, you literally just type in Deer Isle, you would load this mod, and then it'll give you the option to edit Deer Isle as well. But for the purpose of the tutorial, we're just going to do Enoch. So subscribe to it, load it into your mods, hit play, takes you to an offline version of the game, which will allow you to make edits to your map. So, like I said, we are just going to be editing Enoch today because that is currently what my test server is running at the moment. But you can edit any custom map that's uploaded to the Steam's workshop. You can Chinaris, Livonia, Deer Isle, Iztek, Banov, whatever you want. So once we get into the editor, let's go ahead and find a place to put our custom area. And I already have one built. So what I'm going to do is instead of just building something for you, and you know what? No, we'll just build something for you. So let's come over here to Brenna real quick. Now, this isn't going to be nothing freaking spectacular, nothing special. But right here, say we want to put, I don't know. We'll put one of these here. Let's bring it to the ground. We're gonna put one of these. Make sure it's on the ground. And then we'll put, I don't know, one of these. I know Brent already has one of these now, but. So we'll do this. Yeah, they got one right here. And then, for instance, let's grab some of grab one of these, put this here. And then maybe grab one of these buildings. And we'll put it right here. So now that we've got all of our buildings in, this is our custom stuff right here. So normally, what I would have you do, the way I would normally do it, is file export it as an object spawner. So this is how the PC world or the console world would do it. But what's cool about using DayZ Editor Loader is, say this stuff right here, we don't want this stuff. So we're gonna delete this little park, right? So let's delete this, and we can put. We don't want nothing here, so we're just going to delete all of this crap. This is what's really cool about the DayZ editor loader. So we're going to delete all this crap. This wasn't never here. Let's delete some of these fences too. Perfect. All right, look at that. Looks like nothing was ever here. So once we have this, here's our new little mini carnival. So you're gonna file, you're gonna save it as, and just call it, we're gonna call it Enoch Test. Save. Now, if you want these to populate the correct loop, you're going to export a map group POS, and I like to name it the same thing, so we're gonna do Enoch Test. This is perfectly fine. So exporting this format does not support object deletion. Okay. We're good. It's okay. Because all you're doing is you're exporting this, the map group. All right. So, don't worry about its little thing. Just do enoch test. Right there. Good. So, what you're going to do now is you're going to close down the editor. It's all good. Don't worry about the little message. This is what's different now with using DayZ Editor. So once that's done, you can close this down. You're going to come over here and you're going to open up your server files. So once you install DayZ Editor needs to be installed onto the server. So we have DayZ Editor Loader and we have DayZ or Builder Items. Not DayZ Editor, I'm sorry, DayZ Editor Loader. This mod has to be installed. So once you install this mod and you turn your server on for the very first time, let's make sure my server is turned off. It is. It's going to put a folder inside of your missions folder that is called editor files. If it does not create this, you can literally just make this folder yourself. It's perfectly fine. But editor files, it's going to be completely empty. So now what you're going to want to do is you're going to pull up where your files save to. It's always going to be your documents of whatever folder, or I'm sorry, whatever drive your stuff automatically goes to. So documents, DayZ editor. We're going to come on down here. Let's go to enoch-test.dze. So you want to take this DZE file and you want to drag this over into this folder. Okay, so this is what's going to upload it to the server. You don't have to mess with your CFG gameplay files anymore. You can literally just drag this DZE file in, and that's it. This also supports item deletion. The object spawner does not. So once you get this in, now we want our buildings to have loot. So you're going to go to your map group POS. We are going to open up our. We're going to open up. This is our little couple buildings here. So we're going to just grab this. We're going to cut them from here because I'm not going to save this. Let's close this down. Now we're going to come down. This is our vanilla files. What I like to do is do your little less than sign, exclamation point, dash dash, space, and we're going to do, let's just call it test edit for the video purposes. And you go like this. So now once we hit this, we can copy our files in, and we know that this is vanilla. This is what we test. This is like our tested areas. So then what I like to do is I like to do the same thing. Test, edit, end. So this way, if there's ever an issue or something happens and you want to get rid of the area, you don't have to sit here and try and scroll through and figure out, oh crap, where was that stuff at? Now, just a word of advice. If you're going to delete stuff out of your map that contains loot, like the areas that we just deleted, you're going to want to have to come through here into your map group POS, find the area, find which building it is, and you're going to need to delete it. Otherwise, you're going to have floating loot, and I'm going to show you what that looks like here in a second. So once that's done, you hit save and exit, and we are going to go ahead and we're going to start our server. So let's come over here, start, and I will see you in game. Now, remember, like I said, if you're going to delete items from the vanilla map or whatever map you're deleting them from, you need to go into the map group POS and you need to delete those buildings out of that file, and then you need to do a wipe, or you just go and pick the loot up and no more loot will spawn there. Otherwise, the server still thinks that there's a building there and it still thinks that it needs to place loot inside that building. The economy is very fickle inside this program. So, full disclaimer, if you're gonna delete buildings that contain loot, make sure you go into the map group POS and you delete those buildings. So, I don't know where we are, but let's go ahead and go to Brenna, because that's where we added our buildings. So we're gonna come down here to Brenna. This is where we were. So if we go into our fly mode, here's the little carnival crap that we just placed, and here's the little carnival area that we deleted. So if you'll notice, everything's deleted, but look, we still have loot spawning here. So what you're going to end up having to do, if this is going to be the case, is this is what you're going to do, is you're going to have to make sure you go in and you delete these buildings. Otherwise, you'll never, it'll just constantly sit here and spawn loot, which is really aggravating. But I don't know if these areas are going to have loot just yet because we did not do a wipe. They might not. Instead of doing it this way, let's just do it the easy way. And let's just toggle all of our ESP on. Yeah, there's not going to be loot in these buildings just yet. Which is fine. I didn't expect there to be because I didn't do a wipe. If I would have done a wipe, then these buildings would have started populating loot. So, if this is to happen, full disclosure, guys, if you upload this to a live server that has people constantly playing on it, and you don't want to do a wipe, it's okay. Upload the buildings. The server will, over time, the economy will start to sort itself out. I let all of my players know this. Hey, there's a new area being added. Just give it a day or two for loot to populate it fully. So if you add an area and you're like, hey, where's all my loot? I added the map group POS. Don't worry, it'll come. Unless you do a wipe, it'll happen immediately. But if you don't do a wipe, it's just you gotta let the economy do its thing. You gotta let other items, lifetimes go away, and it'll just start to repopulate. That was very rude of you. But that's it. So I personally, I like this way better. I really do. I know for the console versions, you guys can't use this, which really sucks. But for the PC version, I mean, this is so much better. I'm not saying go through and delete a bunch of stuff, but instead of having to mess with the CFG files and you could literally just upload the DZE file, makes it so incredibly easy. So incredibly easy. So that's that. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope it helped. If it did, leave me a like. Share the video with your friends. If it didn't, or if you need help still, feel free to join my Discord. Hit me up. Leave a comment. I really enjoy helping people figure their stuff out. I really enjoy the whole editing and modding the whole world of DayZ. To me, it's much more fun than actually playing the game. But that's that. I don't really know what else I can tell you. Like I said, DayZ Editor Loader has to be a mod that's loaded on the server. And you just drag and drop your DZE files. It's so much easier. So much easier. But yeah, that's that. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Hopefully it helped. Like I said, if you did enjoy it, please feel free to rate the video. Give me a thumbs up. Leave me a nice comment. If not, it's okay. I won't be mad. But, yeah. Catch you guys in the next one. Peace.